Georgia O'Keeffe was one of the most important modernist painters in the 20th century, known as the mother of American modernism. She became one of the most successful American artists despite being a woman in a field dominated by men, and in an era when women were still just starting to enter the workforce. Her best-known painting subjects included enlarged flowers, New Mexico landscapes and animal skulls, and New York skyscrapers, and she was recognized for her meaningful use of color. O'Keeffe was born on November 15, 1887, on a dairy farm in the town of Sun Prairie, Wisconsin. She knew by the age of 10 that she wanted to be an artist. After graduating high school, O'Keeffe studied at the School of the Art Institute of Chicago. She would also study in the Art Students League of New York and at the Teachers College of Columbia University. In 1915, O'Keeffe submitted charcoal drawings to Anita Pulitzer, a photographer whom she had met at Columbia University. Pulitzer then showed the drawings to Alfred Stieglitz, who was a photographer and modern art promoter. Stieglitz loved O'Keeffe's work and exhibited it at his gallery in New York. In 1916, O'Keeffe finally met Stieglitz and they began to regularly correspond. He eventually convinced her to move to New York and the two married in 1924, despite Stieglitz being 23 years older. Stieglitz would photograph O'Keeffe countless times throughout their relationship. He also promoted and showed her work. It has been said that Stieglitz exploited O'Keeffe's femininity when promoting her work, adding fuel to the common critiques that her paintings represented the female anatomy. O'Keeffe largely resented him for this, though some think his strategies helped her to become as successful as she was. O'Keeffe achieved success and recognition in the 1920s, and it was during this time that she made many of her paintings of flowers that garnered comparisons to female genitalia, which were claims that she continued to deny. In her 1927 Radiator Building painting, O'Keeffe comments on those claims by painting a skyscraper because it depicted urban life and masculinity, which implied phallic connotations. Whether or not O'Keeffe was influenced by Freudianism, which was emerging in America at the time, her audience likely was, and that allowed connections to be made with her work that would later inspire other women artists to freely express their sexuality and female forms. Starting in 1929 and continuing into the 1940s, O'Keeffe began to travel to New Mexico for new inspiration, and that is where she would make many of her famous landscapes. She moved to Ghost Ranch in New Mexico in 1940, and after Stieglitz died in 1946, she moved to New Mexico permanently. O'Keeffe would be affected by macular degeneration in her later years, which would greatly impair her vision and limit her art, though she continued working with charcoal and learned to work with clay. She lived to be 98 and died in Santa Fe in 1986. Her work is still exhibited in many museums, and in 1997, a museum opened in Santa Fe that is dedicated to her life and legacy, called the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum. In her famous 1979 feminist art installation, The Dinner Party, artist Judy Chicago honored Georgia O'Keeffe with one of the last seats at the third table honoring important women in history. Chicago saw O'Keeffe as an inspiration and someone who made it possible for her and other women in the 1970s and during the second wave of feminism to express themselves as women. No matter if O'Keeffe ever aligned herself with these feminist artists or feminism, she was considered by them to have made it possible for other women to be successful in art and through their points of views as women. In 1980, Judy Chicago organized the International Honor Quilt, which would become a collective feminist art project that continued to honor women after the dinner party. Women all over the world would submit quilts honoring women they felt deserved to be recognized. O'Keeffe was honored by a quilt even after already being honored in the dinner party. O'Keeffe's quilt was made by a Colorado artist named Allison L. Holmes in 1982. Holmes honored O'Keeffe because she was an inspiration to her as an artist and as a woman. Holmes used traditional quilting techniques and materials from an old cotton mattress pad to make the quilt. The quilt was modeled after O'Keeffe's 1931 painting, Cow Skull, Red, White, and Blue, which is one of her most famous and what she considered herself to be her own attempt at the great American painting. The International Honor Quilt is comprised of 539 quilts and was most recently exhibited at the University of Louisville Height Art Institute. O'Keeffe has continued to be one of the most famous American artists ever, and her work has been some of the most successful ever made by a woman. These groundbreaking accomplishments made O'Keeffe an icon for other women in art, and for second wave feminists who wanted to express themselves sexually, embrace their own female forms, and critique what was sexist and unequal in their society. O'Keeffe was honored in the dinner party and the International Honor Quilt because she had greatly influenced and inspired women and artists, including Judy Chicago, the director of those projects. O'Keeffe was an example for America of an artist successfully expressing herself as a woman during an era of changing sexual and moral values, and she continued to have influence during later eras of women's liberation and activism.